Hey everyone, welcome to Fellowship Youth. We are so glad you're here and we have so much fun stuff planned for you tonight. I'm Bria and I'm a ninth grade girls leader. Shout out to the ninth grade girls, you know who you are. I love you guys. So, like I said, we have so much planned for you guys tonight, but first let me tell you a little bit about what we're about here at Fellowship Youth. So we say this every single week, so if you've been here before, you've definitely heard it, so you can definitely say it with me while you're sitting on your couch, in your room, whatever. So here at Fellowship Youth, we are all about Jesus, we're all about people, and we're all about every single person in every single season of their life. So if you haven't heard that before, you're definitely new, because we say that every single week. So if you're new, we want you to introduce yourself in our chat, go ahead and comment and say, I'm new, it's my first time. And we'll make sure to have someone connect with you just to tell you a little bit more about what we're about and of course kind of share with you the things that come next. Because like I said, we are gonna have so much fun tonight and we wanna make sure that you're up to date. It's gonna be great, it's gonna be so much fun. But yeah, so I want to really quickly tell you guys who is our speaker tonight. If you don't know who he is, he's a great person. You probably see him all the time because he's very, when you see him, he's easy to spot. He's very tall. He used to be a professional football player. I've heard that he is a master on the court in basketball. He's very good. And he's really just one of the nicest people I know. So tonight, our speaker is Daniel Hardy Jr. You guys need to get ready. Buckle your seatbelt belts if you're in a car. I mean, if you're not, then find a seatbelt to buckle into. Daniel's our speaker tonight. He's gonna go in and I know it's gonna be amazing. But first, we're gonna have some worship. So we're gonna just pray into worship really quick. Dear God, thank you so much for every single student and leader that is watching right now. God, thank you so much for just what you have for them tonight with Daniel's sermon and also what you're gonna share with them through worship, God. We just pray that you're able to speak through and share through Daniel tonight, Lord, and that you're able to just communicate exactly what the students here need to hear. We thank you, Lord, even though that we're in such a hard season, we thank you that we have this time to spend together. And I just pray that students are able to be vulnerable and just share exactly how they're feeling and what's going on tonight, Lord, when they're in life group and everything that's gonna just come after this, God. We thank you for what you're doing again. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. So we're gonna go ahead and head into worship, everybody. I'll see you after. Where I wanna be, God.
set a fire. So set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God.
There's no place I'd rather be than here in your love, here in your love. There's no place I'd rather be, no, no place I'd rather be. There's no place I'd rather be than here in your love, here in your love.
His favor be upon you and upon
thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and your children, and the children. May his favor be upon you, and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and your children, and the children. May his presence go before you, and behind you, and beside you, all around you, within you. He's with you, he's with you, in the morning, in the evening, in your coming, in your going, in your weeping, in your rejoicing. He is for you, 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 he is for you.
What's up, Fellowship Youth? My name is Daniel, and it is an absolute honor to be here with you and get to speak this word tonight. I hope you enjoyed worship. It's so powerful every single week, and I'm so thankful for our leaders. So thank you for leading us, worship leaders. But tonight, now, I want to start off with a story. And it began back in 2011, way before I had this epic quarantine beard. And it was the final night of the NFL draft. For those of you who aren't crazy about sports like me, the NFL stands for the National Football League. It's the highest level of football in the world. Now, why am I bringing this story up? Well, you see, that night, I was watching intently to see if my name, that's right, Daniel Ray Hardy Jr. would be called. You see, I had just graduated from the University of Idaho after training for countless hours, after running hundreds of wind sprints, after lifting weight after weight, after sacrificing year after year to be in Idaho for the summer to train with my team, and all to get a shot at achieving my lifelong dream of playing a professional sport. You see, like my shirt says, I was just a kid from Alaska, but now I was gonna see if all my hard work paid off. And I was at Cincinnati. I was in Cincinnati at my agent's house. And I was worried, y'all. I was sweating. It was the last day. It was the final round. And my name had been called. I had broken my arm halfway through my senior season. So I was worried that, you know, I had fallen off the radar of the NFL scouts. I had so much fear that I want to get drafted and that all the hard work that I put in, you know, would be for nothing. And I want to start off with this question and ask y'all, Fellowship Youth, have you ever been there? No, I'm not talking about getting ready to get drafted into an NFL sport. Or a professional sport, rather, but maybe you will one day, except for some of you. But no, I don't mean that. I mean, have you ever been so worried about something that you couldn't stay still? Like, I was pacing back and forth that night. I was like, am I gonna get drafted? Have you ever been there? Have you ever had so much anxiety building up inside of you because of something coming up and you felt like there was no one you could talk to about it, like that no one could understand? Well, this is what my main point for you is tonight. And if you're listening, just lean in. If you're taking notes, write this down. My main point tonight is God is our peace. In those moments, when you have anxiety, when you have worry, when you have fear, God is our peace. I want you to know that there is always, always someone who understands what you're going through. There is always someone you can talk to, and there is always someone who will listen, literally at any time. And that's our Heavenly Father, God Almighty. God is our peace. You know, as we continue our series about our problems versus God's promises, I want us to focus on that. God is our peace. So let's look at our passage for today, and you'll see it on the screen at the bottom here. And it's Matthew chapter 6, verse 26 through 30. And this is what it says. This is Jesus speaking to us. Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? Can any one of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your life? And why do you worry about clothes? See how the flowers of the field grow? They do not labor or spin, yet I tell you that not even Solomon in all his splendor was dressed like one of these. If that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is here today and gone tomorrow, is thrown into the fire, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? You see, Fellowship Youth, what is Jesus saying right here? It's this. What are you afraid about? Why are you worrying so much? Don't you know that I am your provider? You see, Jesus gives us two great examples to look at. The first one is this, that as awesome as birds are, being able to fly wherever they want to, they don't have the ability to grow their own food and crops like us humans do. And they don't have storehouses to keep all that food safe. They don't have a grocery store to go to. Yet God takes care of them all the same and provides them food every day. And the second thing, God says, look at all the beautiful flowers on the planet. Not even King Solomon, a guy we read about in the Bible from ancient times, who was the richest person who ever lived, even though he never had clothes as elaborate or elegant as the 400,000 flower species of the world. Did you know there's 400,000 species of flower? He's saying King Solomon, the richest man who ever lived, didn't have clothes as elaborate or elegant as those flowers. Yet flowers don't dress themselves. God's saying, I do. I provide that too. So Jesus makes this great point that should bring great peace to our mind and to our hearts. He says, you, I'm looking at you, you are much more valuable than birds and flowers. He's talking to you. He says, if I provide for them, don't you know that you can have peace? Because I'm going to provide for you. You're much more valuable to me. There's the promise. God says we are his most valuable creation. So when we remember how valuable we are, we can let go of worry, fear, and anxiety in whatever it is. And in exchange, God will give us great and perfect peace. Again, that is our promise. God is our peace. So let me ask you this question. What is it that brings you anxiety, fear, and worry? What is it that brings anxiety, fear, and worry into your life? I'm sure quarantine has brought up a lot of fears. You know, maybe it's when you have a big homework assignment now that we've started school or a test coming up. Maybe it's a big school project. Maybe it's when you play sports and it happens before every practice or every game. That's what used to happen to me. I used to have so much fear and worry and anxiety. Or when you're getting ready for the NFL draft. No, I'm just kidding. But maybe you're a performer and maybe you get anxiety before a performance or a recital. Maybe it's something you're currently going through with a family member and you don't know who you can go to about it. There's a lot of racial injustices in our country right now, and maybe that's caused some of you to really worry and stress. I know that's affected me this summer. And maybe you're worried about yourself or your friends or your loved ones or just the people in our country. I'm here to tell you, God is our peace. God is your peace. He actually tells us this in the word that we read, that worrying has no benefits. It adds nothing to our life. If anything, it takes away. It takes away from our health. It takes away from our focus. It takes away from our peace. So you know what Jesus is basically telling us? Don't worry. Be happy. Because in me, you have peace. So what would happen that instead of worrying, we actually worship? What would happen if instead of worrying, we worship? And here's my invitation for you tonight. I want to invite you to actually do a couple things tonight. One of those being worship. But the first one is breathe. And I want you to do this. Breathe in and say these words as you breathe in your mind. God is my peace. So this is what we're going to do. You're going to breathe in and say these words in your mind and hold them in your heart. And then breathe out fear, anxiety, and worry. So on the count of three, we're going to breathe in, God is our peace. God is my peace. Hold it for a second in your heart, and then breathe out anxiety, fear, and worry. Okay? You ready? One, two, three. God is my peace. Breathe out that worry, fear, and anxiety. Let's try that again. Gosh, I love the breath of God. Oh, man. So the second part. So breathe. God is my peace. The second part is worship. And so worship is so diverse. Like tonight, we had worship through song earlier. And when I was preparing this message, I actually put on an instrumental. And I like doing that and meditating, just the instrumental music. And that really calms me down and brings me peace. But now I'm going to do a little something, something. I'm actually going to dance. So I got a little song for you. And remember, don't worry, be happy.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy. In every life we have some trouble, but when you worry you make it double. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy now. Don't worry, be happy.
Don't worry, be happy. I hope you enjoyed that as much as I did. I wasn't worried about anybody watching this video thinking Daniel is a fool and a goof and a nerd. And I was just happy. And you know what? I feel so much peace in that. So don't worry, be happy. You can worship. And the last thing, and that leads me to our youth box tonight. Inside your envelope for this week, you'll find post-it notes and a pen. And if you didn't get a box, that's okay. Just grab a piece of paper, something to write with, and a pen or anything. And if you don't have that, pause the video and grab that and then come back. But what we're going to do is we're going to write out something that we're worried, fearful, or anxious about and surrender that to God. And so think about right now something that brings you stress, something that has been causing you anxiety, something that you go to sleep at night, and you just have it on your mind because it just causes you fear. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna take that post-it note and you're gonna write down that fear. You're gonna write down that stress. You're gonna write down whatever that anxiety is. And tonight we have a special activity for you in life groups at 7:30 that we're gonna get into. And so keep that close to you tonight as you go through life groups. But I wanna encourage you, whatever that is, God is your peace. You can surrender all those things to him. Because when you let go of those things, when you let go of fear, anxiety, and worry, in exchange, he will always give you his peace. And that's his promise. My name is Daniel. I hope you enjoy tonight, and I hope you enjoy your life groups. Love y'all, and talk to you soon.
I told you guys, Daniel is great. That word was amazing. God really spoke through him, and the things he shared tonight, I know I'm gonna carry for such a long time. Thank you so much, Daniel, for sharing. I'm really excited for us to discuss that in Life Group, which is what is next. So if you don't know where to go, go ahead and go to our landing page, which is madeforfellowship.com/youth. And then you're gonna go ahead and click on that Zoom link and we will meet you there. It's gonna be a fun time. I'll see you so soon.